how a child can really take its toll on a marriage because the baby hasn't even come out yet. And I am already so resentful towards my husband. So much resentment, especially when he asked me to do shit around the house. Hey, can you wash the dishes? No! Can you water the plants? I'm not doing jack shit anymore. I'm busy making an eyeball, okay? Are you making a foot? I didn't think so. You changed the channel. I can already see how there's like this crazy double standard in our society of how it takes so little to be considered a great dad. And it also takes so little to be considered a shitty mom. People praise my husband for coming to all of my doctor's appointments with me. Oh my God, I can't believe he comes to all your doctor's appointments. He is so supportive. Guess who else has to go to those doctor appointments? Me, I'm the star of the show. There's nothing for the camera to see if I'm not there. But he's the hero for playing Candy Crush while I get my blood drawn. Meanwhile, if I do mushrooms 7 months pregnant, I'm a bad mommy.
I'm learning things from my fam. I'm learning how to play. Oh, because black people don't play. We don't play. Some of the first things that we were taught as a kid, right? You over there acting up. Your parents tell you, hey, you better stop playing. Oh, you think I'm playing with you? Keep playing here, keep playing, keep playing. Learn how to play. White people play all the time. Just make up shit. You don't even know what you're playing. Just play. I had to learn this. Like, we had a birthday party over the weekend. So during the week, you know, there's still some balloons floating around. I get up Monday morning, I'm coming downstairs. My son takes a balloon, kicks it, and it hits me right in the face. First thing I do, boy, you better stop playing. He laughs, he takes another balloon, kicks it, almost knocks my glasses off. I'm like, oh, Luke, you think I'm playing with you? Keep playing with me. Keep playing with me here. My wife hears me yelling. She runs in the living room. Baby, what's the problem? Qu'est-ce qui se passe? Huh? Ça va? Ça va? No. No, it's not ça va. You want to know what? I'll tell you what happened. Lucas here just kicked me in the face, and now I'm hearing myself. Lucas kicked me in the face with the balloon. I haven't had coffee yet, okay? First. And he did it twice, it was that little knot part, the knot part on the balloon. You know that little knot in the balloon? Yeah, that knot part hit me right. You were playing, huh? You were playing. I'm sorry, baby. I didn't know you were playing. Okay, stop crying. Stop crying. It's okay. All right. You gotta let me know we playing or something. I didn't know, right? So my wife just looked at me like I was an asshole. Yeah. So he goes off to school and she's like, what is your problem? Why did you? I said, look, first of all, you need to take it down a notch, all right? You ain't gonna be in my face like this, okay? And second of all, I behave the way I was supposed to behave, okay? All right? I'm a black woman, all right? I come downstairs in my living room, and this little white boy kicks me in the face.
That's why I don't fuck with my family to this day. I do not fuck with my family, y'all. Because 5 years ago, I went home to Atlanta to celebrate with my family because it was the first time we was all out of jail at the same fucking time. I pull up in Atlanta and my niece called me. She was like, Auntie, I need a favor. I'm like, what do you want? She said, my sister is homeless and she got 4 kids. One of the babies are 2 weeks old. Can they please come live with you? I know you just built a big ass house in Indiana. And I said, fuck no, bitch. Them crack babies ain't coming to my house and right on my new walls. My son was in the car with me. He's like, Mama, you should help her out. I'm like, why? He said, because when you was down and out, somebody helped you out. Do you remember the time my daddy shot you in the back of the head, drug you behind that truck, and gave you them STDs? I'm like, damn, nigga, you remember all that shit? Let's go get the crack babies and their mama. I go over and I pick up my niece and I take her back to my husband with the 4 kids. I'm like, look, the crack babies and their mama coming to live with us. On the way home from Atlanta to Indiana, y'all, my chest started hurting really bad. So I tell my husband, pull the fuck over, my chest hurt. I'm having a heart attack. He was like, calm down, your ass ain't having no heart attack. He said, what you having is an anxiety attack. I'm like, what the fuck make you think I'm having that? He was like, look in the back seat. You just picked up 5 niggas and you don't know how you gonna feed them. I get my niece back to Indiana, y'all. I help her get off drugs. I co-sign for a car, a job, apartment, every fucking thing. 2 years in, this bitch run off and leave me with these 4 crack babies. Don't all just a crackhead story. It's a good ending. Now I'm raising a 5 or 7. I don't know how old these motherfuckers are. They just still at my fucking house. And let me just say this to y'all. This is not my first set of crack babies I've raised. This is my 3rd fucking set. I raised my sister kids, my sister-in-law kids, now I got my niece kids. I had to go talk with God. I said, look, God, I'm done being your crack baby keeper. You gotta find somebody else for this shit. I'm too old. Because I don't know if y'all know anything about crack babies, but these new crack babies ain't nothing like these fucking 90s crack babies. These new motherfuckers come with technology. I got a 5-year-old running around my house. Where my iPad at? I'm like, how the fuck you can work an iPad but you shit on yourself? Can you Google how to shit in the toilet? Can Elsa show you how to let it go the right way?
I've wanted to be a parent for a very long time, and it is such a tremendous experience. And I feel like Stephanie and I are doing a great job. I really do. And I do, but I also feel like it would be reasonable if somebody had called Child Protective Services a couple of times. A couple of times, you know, it happens. You have a rough day or a weird day. No, when Max and Finn were just a couple months old, we were so amused because people would come over to meet the babies, and what we would do is we'd prop them up with our hands underneath their armpits, and then we'd just say, yep, they're pretty much walking, and then we'd let go, and then their little noodle legs would buckle. And then we'd catch them 1/2 inch before they hit the ground. Oh, is that a treat. If you have a baby, I highly recommend trying this out. If you don't have a baby but know someone with a baby, ask to borrow the baby. Nobody will regret this. The baby's clueless, just like, meh. They're just a blob. And you catch it. That's the key. You have to catch them. You can't just let the little blobs fall because that's when there's true trouble. Well, with all of the exhaustion and busy lives, it's hard to keep up with the house in the way that we did before. And I was sitting on the couch and Max toddled over to me and handed me a gigantic, gross ball of cat hair and lint. And the thing is at their age, they put everything in their mouths, but he even knew, you have to get this out of my reach. me and my brother here. We need you to remove this. And I just looked at it, I was like, oh, this is icky. This is so gross, yes. And I dropped it behind the couch. We got Max and Finn, these little, we call them their cars. And these little things they sit in, there's four tiny wheels underneath them and a plastic tray in front of them. And I somehow figured out that Finn loves when I kick his little car and he shoots across the room at a high speed. And then he scoots back towards me and then I kick him again. Here's the problem. The entire front of our house is just all windows. And there's a sidewalk that runs along our house, and the neighbors were walking by. And all they saw was me kicking and this tiny little baby head flying to the back of the house at very high speed. And then just scooting back towards me and then kicking again. And at that point, I just thought, okay, I have to close these curtains. But then we just kept making memories. Me and Finn.